What doesn't kill you makes you so much stronger, stronger. Well, ever since her phenomenally successful debut record, Innocent Eyes, she has become one of the highest-selling and most loved Australian recording artists. Delta Goodrem, it is an absolute honour to be speaking with you today.
Thank you. And the honour is mine. Thank you, guys.
Now, 2012 has been such a huge year for you.
Yeah.
Can you tell us what the highlight has been?
You know what? I think, like, the highlight's just to come because the album's just coming out. And I feel really excited that, like, all this time, like, just having Child of the Universe ready to go. I mean, obviously, I can look back and say The Voice was a real highlight as well because it was an incredible, incredible chapter. But yeah, it's been a really, you know, challenging but amazing year. But now I feel like it's a different moment again, like having Wish You Were Here in Child of the Universe. I don't know, it feels different again. I feel different again. It's about to be the highlights, I think.
Yeah. Well, congratulations on Child of the Universe, your fourth studio record. Musically, what can fans expect?
You know, I think, like, you know, I've always sort of done, you know, what I do and written it the way I do. And I think at this time it's a little more literal in some of its, this record. There's a little more you know, I can be very fantasy. I love sort of ethereal and I love, you know, going into that world. But I was quite literal in some of the lyrics on this one.
From a writing perspective, what was the process like for this record? How do you get into your creative zone?
I mean, I think, you know, I always say to people that, you know, you can be good every day, but then, you know, when special moments come and great moments come, they don't come all the time. It's something that you have to channel and something you have to, you know, sort of really listen to the universe and listen what's happening and then sort of take from there and be able to bring it through your fingers and onto the piano. And I kind of let myself have a bit of space to breathe and to be able to do that. And, you know, I feel in my heart like I can distinguish between, you know, really good ones and I can write every day and do it. And then kind of songs that I go, oh, that really tugs on my heartstring, so I know that that'll tug on other people's heartstring, or people will feel this because I really feel it, you know, because everyone goes through the same things in different ways. And yeah.
Sitting on Top of the World was the first single from the record. Does it still surprise you when one of your songs is multi-platinum selling like it was?
Yeah, definitely. Like, I never know what to expect. I never release a song and think, you know, I know what's going to happen, because I just don't. I just have no idea. Yeah, it's crazy. I'm so thankful. So thankful for anyone who buys it and it's at their home. Thank you. Just makes me excited because then I know people are going to know that song on the shows and I know everyone will sing along. So that's kind of the part that gets, like, it's awesome.
Wish You Were Here is the next single that you're releasing. It has some particularly special meaning to you, I believe.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, every song is I'm very big on the lyrics, making sure that they're a part of, you know, a string to what's gone on. And but this one in particular, I mean, I wrote many a songs about the topic of the fact that I lost one of my best friends, Liam. And, you know, 24 when it happened, and it was one of those first kind of very intense, you know, where you can't really wrap your head around what's happened. It's very abstract. And on his birthday, on January 18th, I sat down and I was like, today, it's his birthday. And I was like, I need to write it today. And I'd written lots of okay ones. And I was like, okay, this and this. It's like, I need to write his song today. I'm not leaving his birthday today without writing that song for him. Like, to keep his memory alive and to, you know, express what I know a lot of people would feel, and that's, you know, when you lose someone that you wish they were here still. And so I just sat down and, you know, the mood comes through the fingers and you just find something, and it really was quite a spiritual moment. And
wow.
And I wrote the song for him, and now I feel really peaceful that that's the song coming out of the record. Like, more than sitting and dancing, I feel very like I'm getting to, this song's getting space around it.
I wish you were here.
Video, we just kind of go through the symbolism of being in the barn playing the piano, and it's very dark, and there's these beautiful, you know, strips of light coming through, you know, symbolizing soul and spirit, And then we kind of have like the growing up, like the memories kind of owed to like just growing up. And although, like, you know, it's funny, like, you know, because you can only do so much trying to tell the story in like a video and stuff. And then it was like, it's really awesome because there's these two young kids and they were so cute, like just, you know, playing kind of us. And then I had a couple of, you know, people that were two other characters, Jackie and Daniel, my other best mates. And so we kind of just tried to do that, and then just, you know, show that there was an accident. It wasn't exactly the car, but yeah. And then it was just growing up, just showing that there's a growing up and memories and reflecting on them, and then kind of just singing the truth at the piano. Have you ever stepped into the
Fans of yours, I'm sure, will be very keen to hear about you touring this record. You know, can you let us know what you've got planned, and will there be any surprises?
It's always surprises. Life is a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. I think, like, there is some surprises. I mean, I love putting together a show. This show will have all the hits, like all songs everybody knows and you can sing along with, you know, kind of playing with them a bit. And then little surprises I like to do, because it has to have, you know, it's the same with the album, like it has to have the gamut of colour wheel, you know, it has to have all the different emotions. And, you know, I like to have, you know, just like we are as humans, quite complex. Like, we like to be, you know, have fun and have a joke, and then we like to be serious and reflective. And then, you know, you want to just kind of just get up and rock out, and then you want to be a bit more kind of intimate and just have a bit of a play on the instruments. So there's all of that. You know.
And how involved are you in like the creative and the production process of touring?
Well, what I've found is that there's this incredible like mythology of like that these people are magically do it like around you. When, let me tell you, guess what? You do it. You know, like, the artist does it. Like, I would love to meet these magical people that do it. But I have a wonderful team, absolutely, that I work with. But creatively, I mean, I've been the heart and soul since the day I started, and I'm really proud of that, and it's my forte. Like, I love to put together a show. I think that that's actually what I, you know, writing a song and putting together a show is actually, you know, what I do. And I'm not actually a professional, like, interviewee, like, you know, but, you know, because you have to work so much, you talk a lot, and, you know, all that kind of stuff you just learn to do. But I've just finished the set list, and I've been sending it to my band, and they're really excited. And
awesome.
Then we'll be getting emails back by my guitarist. It was this one, he was like, you know, sitting back, I've got this great sound for that one. I was like, I've just put this together. What do you think? And so,
it's very collaborative.
Yeah, I love it. I've been, you know, I think that's why people also resonate with an artist, because if it comes from them, people know.
There are so many components to this industry. You talked about doing interviews, and there's obviously writing and recording and touring. Which do you like best, and why?
The start. It's the start and the end of a cycle. I love to write, you know, music, obviously. And then I like to tour it, and then everything else is kind of part of it. And you know, I'm thankful for my life. I get to live with music, but you know, my heart and soul is on stage. Like, when the light hits and you're there, and you're just like, it's like the most calm I am. Like, it's really bizarre.
Yeah. Does Delta Goodrem ever get nervous?
Oh yeah. Occasionally, okay. You know, I get butterflies, but they're good butterflies. And you know, when I was a kid, and I used to do like a lot of sport. And I would get so nervous to the point of like feeling sick, that it wasn't good nerves for me. But I would get nervous for music, but really excited to do it. Like, I can't wait to do it. I'd be more nervous waiting. Like, I'm like, come on, let's go.
You are a huge star in Australia now. You've got hundreds of thousands of followers on Twitter and likes on Facebook. What does it mean to you to be a role model for so many people around the world?
I take it as a great responsibility, and I've never shied away from that. I honour that, and I try the best I can. I mean, I learn like everybody else does in the moment. If there's some sort of crazy things, extreme things going on around me, and I don't even sometimes know how they happen, but I just try and do the best I can, and I take it with great pride. I don't think it's uncool. I think it's extremely cool to be a good role model, when I say that, I, you know, try and just be a good person and be motivated by the right things of love and compassion for people, and trying to give something to them. Otherwise, I don't understand why anyone would, you know, be in public eye for no reason. Like, I just, you know, you want to be able to give a craft and be motivated by it and work hard.
And do you have a life philosophy or kind of a motto that you live by?
I do. I have lived by since the time I was born, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing well. Otherwise, I don't do it. And it seems so simple, but it's honestly what I've lived by. I'm like, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing well. Like, I don't do anything unless I, like, you know, ATD, attention to detail. Like, just otherwise, don't bother. Otherwise, I'm not going to. Otherwise, I'll say no and I won't be a part of it.
Yeah. We've heard recently, I think, about you doing a tour with, or a show with Dave Stewart in the US, which sounded amazing. How are things going for you in America? What was that like?
So awesome. Yeah. Like, it was just, I love Dave Stewart and I love the Eurythmics my whole life. And I ran into Dave and we crossed paths. He was like, I'm singing at the Troubadour on Friday. Do you want to get up as well? And I was like, I'd love to, like, of course. John Mayer got up, Colby Calais, Orianthe was there, and Vanessa was there, and it was some really cool group. Like, it was...
Lots of Aussies.
Yeah, lots of Aussies. Like, yeah. I was like, how are you attracting the Aussies, Dave? but he asked me to sing Your Place to Chill in My Heart, and we got to just him on guitar and me sing, and it was so awesome. I had a ball.
Really keen to collaborate with who you haven't worked with yet?
You know, it's really funny because I was so fortunate that, you know, from a really young age, I got to work with my my idols. You know, I sort of, you know, got to write on Celine Dion's albums and Olivia Newton-John and all these, like, and then Michael Bolton, obviously, recently, and sing with Andrea. So I've got to work with some, you know, just incredible artists. But I'd be, you know, I'm so open to, like, I just love music that I'm happy to have a jam with everybody. I mean, yeah.
Lead us to a place, guide us with your grace, give us faith so we'll be saved.
You did so well on The Voice. It was such a phenomenal success as a show. Are you looking forward to the next season?
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm really excited. I mean, we learnt a lot last year. We learnt I need a better sales pitch. But other than that, I just, like, yeah, I loved it. I loved it. So I'm looking forward to it next year.
Awesome.
But we're going to miss Keith.
Yes, I know,
so
aren't we?
Big shoes to fill.
Very big shoes.
Whoever it is, big shoes to fill, okay?
Well, Delta's beautiful new single, Wish You Were Here, can be downloaded now at Big Pond Music or streamed via Mog. And the new record, Child of the Universe, is out on the 26th of October. Make sure you check it out. Thank you, Delta Goodrem.
Thank you.